Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol SANP. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So while this here may look like several days worth of time, it's actually today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like you this time frame. I think it's a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping out levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. I did this analysis yesterday, so that is where these red and green line annotations here are coming from. And want to get things updated here. Final 30 minutes, not the greatest. However, the bulls do still have plenty of opportunity, and I'll explain what I mean by that. However, there is some perspective that goes into this, so this is why the analysis is kind of tricky. What do I mean by perspective? Well, if you're a day trader and you bought up there, or maybe you bought right there and you wanted to sell within 25 minutes after buying, then yeah, for you, the chart's looking kind of rough. Now, if you care about the big picture of things, yeah, I realize the price did pull back today, especially during that 30 minutes. But from the big picture, the bulls do still have an opportunity to build at a higher base. And as long as you have higher bases being built over longer periods of time, that's how long-term uptrends are constructed. I am going to be talking about things from a big picture perspective. So if I sound crazy calling something bullish, my guess would be you just had a different outlook and strategy going into the trade. And case in point, right here in regards to that purple line, which is the 50 period simple moving average. I talked about this in yesterday's video. But let's say that the price essentially comes down here and still hovers right around that area. So essentially 0005, does something like this, and then starts to work its way back upwards. Now, emphasis on big picture. From the big picture perspective, what would you have? Well, you'd have a set of lows right here. You'd have this previous set of lows down here before things came to life. You picture these as stair steps. And again, from the big picture, you'd still very clearly have stair steps progressing in the upwards direction. And that's the name of the game. That's what you want to see. You want to see progress being made forward. And I'm defining quote unquote progress as 0005. Now, once more, I'm well aware that if you're a day trader and you bought a pair, then yeah, you couldn't care less about these big, you know, stair steps and, you know, 0005. But that's why I try to offer up a warning that I would be making these comments from a big picture perspective. So sure, today the price pulled back, but stop and think about that word today, as in one day. Looking at multiple days, which we're doing here, you can see the bulls do still have an opportunity to build a higher base. So that is certainly priority number one going forward, building a higher base. So let's see if the bulls can get the job done or not. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.